Prune your perennials. It's game time. Produced a great leader. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Which one of us?
Both of us.
Really?
No, just me. Hello and welcome to X-Play.
Today's games feature high-intensity adrenaline thrills target-marketed to adolescent boys who aren't allowed to leave home without their asthma medication.
Activities like the phlegm and bone fragment catapulting fisticuff of Spikeout Battle Street.
The high-speed crashes and daring spinner-rib installations of Need for Speed Underground 2.
And antagonizing girls by destroying cute things in Raze's hell.
All this plus another edition of Splinter Cell Co-op Theater and a game for cheap bastards.
But first, a game that manages to take the fun out of mindless mayhem.
Oh, yeah.
Here's Spikeout Battle Street.
Welcome to the world of Spikeout Battle Street, where masculine stereotypes engage in furious fisticuffs for control of an industrial island whose importance is never actually explained. This guy sure wants it, though.
Vengeance will soon be mine!
Man, nothing's changed. Place is still a dump. Oh, what's up?
It's been so long, Junior.
Spike Jr., the son of a legendary street fighter, returns to Dieseltown to find anarchy in the streets and his father nowhere to be found.
Enough of this touchy-feely stuff. Just answer my question. Why am I here?
This begins a long string of horribly written, acted, and rendered cutscenes.
I'll clean up Dieseltown, I promise. But Dad's on his own.
Junior, wait! Where is he going? He's just walking out toward nothing. Spikeout is a beat-em-up in the vein of such classics as Streets of Rage, Double Dragon, and River City Ransom. However, the execution of Junior's adventures in pugilism fails to live up to the promise of its pedigree.
I wouldn't have promised something stupid like that. And I told you, stop calling me Junior.
God, you're an idiot.
You're such a jerk, Junior.
The best beat-em-ups have depth and technique beneath the seemingly simple exterior. Spikeout lacks any depth whatsoever. The tutorial is red flag number one.
How to see the map. Start. Gate. Player. Boss.
Pro tip, don't die. You have one six-hit combo you'll use over and over. The announcer never ceases to be impressed by this. Choose between a too-short story mode and a timed run through all the stages. There's a jump button and a strong attack that can be charged for three different levels of attack effects. And that's it.
No fooling?
No fooling. That's the whole game. Trudge through environments that look like they just stepped out of a five-year-old arcade game, beating up the same thugs dozens of times over, while a busybody baritone invokes the obvious.
Here comes the boss.
Uh-oh, look busy! Even with the subpar visuals and tiny stages, Spikeout loads more often than a BioWare game on muscle relaxants.
Here I go!
Yes, here you go staring at barrels while the next section loads very slowly. Other games stream entire cities off the disc. Spikeout instead pioneers the first-person load screen.
It's amazing how messed up this island is.
Wait till I get going! If you die, that's it. No continues. You go back to the beginning of a level.
Game over.
You can't skip the cutscenes until the interminable load times are finished, so you'll be repeatedly subjected to inane dialogue and vaguely homoerotic overtones ad nauseum.
You're not my enemy. I can tell.
I was thinking the same thing. You're strong.
Not as strong as you, man. I could see that.
Are they just gonna go for it right there on the pavement?
Actually, I'm here to find someone.
As am I. I seek a man.
Try where the sailors hang out. The one potential saving grace of Spikeout is multiplayer. Or would be if Xbox Live wasn't deserted. Split screen is also an option, but if you were dumb enough to pay money for Spikeout, you probably don't have many friends to begin with.
You gonna throw down, or are we cool?
Apparently, we're cool.
Totally. If by cool, you mean a 1 out of 5.
This game sucked. And you know, if they were gonna set it somewhere called Diesel Island, I would really expect to see more well-dressed Asian guys in Italian-cut jeans.
And the fighting system, well, it was just so lame. I mean, what's the fun of beating someone up if it's just that simple? Ow!
I know.
It's gonna leave a bruise. Okay, while I manage myself, here's a review of Need for Speed Underground 2.
Hey, it's a car racing game. Somebody alert the media for this little piece of history. But if the man is gonna keep making them, we're gonna keep covering them. That's our job.
That's our curse.
And straight from the constantly moving conveyor belt of commonplace games comes yet another for the DS system. Need for Speed Underground 2. The Need for Speed series has been around longer than Tupac's recording career, so this new game won't be sending shockwaves through the industry. It's certainly not a bad game. It services your general DS racing requirements. The cars look all right. It won't embarrass you to play it in public. It's just kind of, well, standard. It's pretty much trackless, except for a few that take you through construction sites and airports. Because in this day and age, who doesn't love speeding through airports? Basically, we've got two types of races here, drag and course racing. Nothing surprising there. At least you get a good sense of speed in the game, and it handles pretty well. Nothing wrong with that. It's just all been done before. And here's the proof, a little X-Player racing game montage that we simply call Time Filler. You can customize your cars here, a concept as original as nothing. Look, a choice of rims. Rims! They spinning and spinning and spinning and spinning. The DS capabilities aren't being used to the fullest here, as the top screen ignores the bottom like Tom Cruise ignores his publicist. If we have to get right down to it, DS hasn't really brought us a good racing game yet. Need for Speed Underground 2 is no better and no worse than any other DS racing game. We're still waiting for a good one. Need for Speed Underground 2 gets 3 whatevers out of 5.
Well, that sure was a racing game.
Yeah, it had cars and customizable hood swoops and it had drag racing. It had drag racing that was almost kind of fun.
Personally, I just like to see one racing game do something interesting. Squirrels racing in chariots, racing in those big fan boats that are in the Everglades they always had on Simon and Simon, or drag racing in drag, anything to kill the boredom.
I approve of any game that involves customizing your own wig. Game developers, the next move is yours.
Coming up, slightly less boring than Billy Crystal's one-man show, it's Splinter Cell Co-op Theater.
Invasion of the Fantanas.
Checking in can take its toll. Check out Phantom, nice and cold.
Where on earth will they show up next? If you're not having fun, they'll find you.
Waiting for your chance to scream. Phantom helps you beat the steam.
You could be next.
Don't you wanna?
Man, this 555 deal's really popular.
Mr. Trump, here you go, 3 medium pizzas, $5 each.
Tell you what, I'll counter that offer with an even better one. Here's the deal. You give me those 3 pizzas, only I'll give you just $5 apiece.
Sure. Okay.
Still got it, Donald. Still got it.
Call now and get 3 or more medium one-topping pizzas for just $5 each. Get the door. It's the Domino's 555 deal.
We'll be right back.
We're a pretty tight group here.
That doesn't happen overnight. People have to learn if they can count on you. You know what I mean?
All the power!
Yes, sir, I do.
Get strength for now, strength for later. Learn more at GoArmy.com.
Delta Force Blackhawk Down. Intense single-player missions push you to the limit. The largest multiplayer battlefields on console take you to the cutting edge of online gaming. Delta Force Blackhawk Down, the video game. In stores now. Rated T for teen.
This week on Real Time, presented by Coca-Cola. Get the lowdown on the world of video games with 10 back-to-back episodes of Icons.
It's the genesis of the video game industry.
Yeah! Tomorrow at 1 Eastern, 10 Pacific.
Coming up on the Whipset, Street Fury ponders the eternal question, JDM or DTM?
JDM!
DTM for sure.
Makes new friends in Mexico, then heads to a bikini contest you don't want to miss. The Whipset, tomorrow, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific.
Two looking for a group for Older Man, it's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to X-Play. In 2002, the American Theater Wing named X-Play the finest regional theater in the country.
With this honor, we received a grant of $25,000 to continue producing quality theater. Since then, we've spent most of the money on bourbon and speculative real estate ventures.
Well, of course. But now, to fulfill our contractual obligations to those ball breakers in the Broadway community, we now present yet another edition of Splinter Cell Co-op Theater.
When America needs a hero, when freedom stands alone, when justice needs to be upheld, there's only one place to turn. Through the cover of night, America's top agents will defend our liberty from those who wish us harm. Let us join Special Agent Bob and Secret Agent Steve, two of the finest official unofficial Splinter Cells.
What are we watching?
Grabnar the Wanderer.
What?
Yeah, Grabnar is a medieval monk with the powers of the god Kniathan. He wanders from town to town.
Doing what?
Mainly killing people.
Could you give me a little room, Bob?
Actually, you can call me Thorax the Impaler.
What?
It's cool, huh? Or do you like that, or do you like Ramrod the Destroyer?
Are you retarded? Look, your name is Bob, and I'm calling you Bob.
Who is this Bob that you speak of, fellow wanderer?
You've got to be kidding me.
Thorax the Impaler never speaks in jest.
Bob, would you just help me rappel down?
Thorax.
God's sake, we have a job to do. The government is depending on us, and you do this shit all the time.
You have spirit, little one. I will call you Steve the Vagina.
Listen, Thorax, just lower the rope.
Fare thee well, you angry little gnome.
I hope Grabnar smites you.
Lord of the skies, it is I, Thorax. Hear my call.
You realize that the thorax is a part of an insect, right?
No, you see, I spell it T-H-O-R hyphen A-X-E. It's totally different.
All right, lower the rope.
Thorax the Impaler bows before no man. Feel my power.
Did you just throw... Ah! God damn it!
Submit to my will and you will be saved. Challenge me and you will be destroyed.
What is wrong with you? Ah! Are you insane?
Submit to my will!
Jesus, okay, I submit to your will.
And whose will is that?
Thorax the Impaler.
Good. And who is submitting?
Please don't.
Would you like another bolt from a god mortal? What is your name?
Steve.
Steve what?
Steve the Vagina.
You may ascend.
If I didn't need to get out of here, I'd kill you.
Oh, come on, it was a joke.
You threw grenades at me!
They were flash grenades. I wouldn't throw real grenades at you. I mean, come on, that would just be stupid. Steve?
What?
Are you mad?
No. There's a ton of guards out there, so shut up and get down.
Thorax the Impaler hides from no man!
Bob, don't! Wow, it worked.
Thorax impales all.
If it worked once, it can work again, so let's just run out there and kill him. Navy SEALs!
is why they call you Steve the Vagina.
What the hell? You were supposed to back me up.
Thorax the Impaler knows not to fight when he cannot win.
Join us next week when Steve and Bob disarm more terrorists with their amazing cunning and stealth.
Whee! Yeah! It's like being in a car wash!
I wish we were soapy and wet.
One step ahead of you, buddy. Hey, Steve. Steve, where are you going? Steve? Be mad?
They just make the cutest couple. To think that some people would deny those men a place in our armed forces just because they're so completely in love.
Of course, there's a place for them. We can station them at Fort Dix. Get it, Fort Dix.
No, Adam, even Navy SEALs are too scared to go to New Jersey.
Yeah.
Up next, because Mama lost her paycheck at the Indian casino, it's Games for Cheap Bastards.
New Mega M&M's. You wouldn't want them any bigger.
Wilcox! How far would you go to get cash to buy video games? EB Games hopes that this scene is not familiar to you, because it doesn't have to be. There's an easier way, pal. Why not trade in your used games for cash? Trade DVD movies for cash. And the same for music CDs. Trade for sweet piles of cash. It's easy, it's quick, and not likely to give you hepatitis B. EB Games and Electronics Boutique. Trade for cash. Trade for games.
I see you've been working on your game.
Yeah, son.
Remember when you got burned down in Miami?
Yeah, I remember. You look like this. Woo! Remember in Jersey when you got took?
Yeah, I remember. Something like this. What? Oh, what you got, Rich? Remember when you got your ankles broken, Phoenix?
Yeah, I remember. If you don't look like this.
Oh, like this.
Like this. Like this.
Oh!
Oh, it definitely didn't look like that.
Nike Shock's lethal.
Yeah, Foot Locker.
See you tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow.
Like this.
Like this.
Earn a college degree in the U.S. Navy. Proudly display your school colors. Navy, accelerate your life.
In today's busy world, going to the video store is a hassle. With Netflix, you just make a list of the movies you want to see, and you'll get your first DVDs in about one business day. Keep them as long as you want without late fees. Return one in this prepaid envelope, and they'll automatically send you another movie from your list.
My lady, we are the romance movie from Netflix. We hope our presence will be to your liking.
There's a movie waiting for you at home. Netflix. All the DVDs you want, starting at only $9.99 a month, no late fees.
Jason, from California.
Kathy, Michigan.
Today, thousands of people will go to progressive.com, where they'll get their quote for car insurance and see what other people have been quoted as well. Whether Progressive is the highest or the lowest, you'll see it all. Go to progressive.com, because the more you know, the easier it is to make a smart decision.
They are likely to be eaten by a GRU. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to X-Play. Periodically, we all face financial troubles of one sort or another.
Maybe the investment banking firm you own runs afoul of the SEC.
Maybe your baby mama runs off with all your bling.
Maybe your mom reduced your allowance because you refused to apply yourself in health class. Regardless of the reason, here are some great games for folks on a fixed budget.
Well, dear friends, the time has come. Once more, we fly into the breach and take a look at the forgotten. The passed by, the overlooked.
My God, look at that.
But most importantly, the cheap. These are the games you might have thought about at one time, but they're just too expensive for your oh-so-conservative lifestyle. You damn cheap bastards. These are games for cheap bastards, brought to you by EB Games.
When you have to blame it on something, when you just have to blame it on something, blame it on Bloodrayne. Bloodrayne 2, that is. Released late in 2004, this sequel might have been overlooked by some, or it was just too expensive for your cheap little grubby hands. Well, no more, cheapos. Now you can relive all the violence that goes along with vampire hunting without the raging ego of Sarah Michelle Gellar Prince Jr. Plus, more blood than a night out with Robert Blake. What better way to be desensitized to violence by playing as the sultry Bloodrayne?
Ooh, that's definitely stimulating my economy.
The sexiest vampire hunter this side of Wesley Snipes. Did I say that out loud?
Yes. Yes, I did.
All right, bitch.
NBA Street Volume 2, the Jan Brady of NBA Street Games. It wasn't the first, and it's not the latest, but it can be had for under 20 bucks, just like Jan Brady. Volume 2 is better than the first one in every way possible. Better look, better gameplay, and moves so sweet, they should be illegal. And that's not a crack against Kobe. Of course, it always brings a tear to my eye to see Shaq and Kobe as teammates. At least they have something in common these days, sitting out the finals. And here's Ron Artest, which, as always, leads to this. So, if Volume 3 is out of your price range, this one shouldn't be.
Let me hear you say ho!
Hey, remember when the final movie of a trilogy was supposed to be satisfying? Well, let's return to the glory year of 2003 for a book-slash-movie-based game that lived up to its Hayden Christensen-list potential. The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. There were no younglings hurt in this game. Yes, revisit old friends such as Gandalf, Aragorn, and Elijah Wood, who's still living in the Shire, by the way. Rent control. Ah, Return of the King, so satisfying, so action-filled, and now, so cheap. And there you have it. Three games under 20 bucks apiece. Three good choices to get you through the doldrums of summer. You may not be as cool as your highfalutin big-spending friends, but at least you'll have some extra cash in your pocket. And money is the most important thing in the world.
Oh, man, it's getting ugly in here.
Take it from me. I'm freaking loaded.
To know that the erotic mayhem of Bloodrayne 2 will now be available to families on a fixed income.
Even America's Social Security dependent seniors can now afford to buy Bloodrayne 2 and get one more chance to stick it to those Nazis.
You know, World War II probably would have gone a lot smoother the first time if we'd employed a squad of half vampire seductresses.
Well, there's always the next war.
Coming up, watch out, Dakota Fanning. Raze's hell makes the world unsafe for the adorable.
I was here first.
Yeah, but I saw it first.
It's mine.
No.
Yeah.
Give me this gun.
No.
This is mine.
Gotta have sweet. Gotta have new, longer-lasting juicy fruit.
Trident Strawberry Fusion Flavor has two great tastes all in one pack. One sweet, one sour. Trident, a mouth's best friend.
For all those who believe a second isn't worth much, just remember, in 1 second, you make your move. In 1 second, you change direction, you avoid a sack. It all comes clear. You hit the man, you make the play. In 1 second, the game changes, the tide turns. A city cheers, and a hero is born. In 1 second, you decide to work hard, to dig deep, and to explode. In 1 second, the Nike Shox 45 at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
You know what's insane? You can control the Black Eyed Peas with the push of a button.
F-R-E-S-H, be fresh. D-E-F, that's right, we definite. We definite. Black Eyed Peas, be reppin' it.
Turn up the radio, blast your stereo
ride. The music, the stuff, it all comes together right here. Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
What's Donuts with people lately?
Introducing new Triple Threat. It fuels like a power bar and tastes like a candy bar.
Taste, energy, nutrition.
One bite and you'll feel like you can take on anything. Power bar. Be great.
Well, how come you haven't called me back?
Because I was drunk and just using you for sex, okay?
Really?
Brutally honest, watch X Play. Next.
Sunday nights.
What?
Go undercover. Fast lane.
Have you heard a new splash? This year gonna play some games.
They're not the best cops. Just the best looking.
Oh, yes. kind of confused about the do's and don'ts of police work.
That party was off the hook!
Fastlane, tomorrow night, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, on The Whip Set.
Hoping that it's just a rash, it's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Yeah, hoping. Welcome back to X-Play, America's premier source for opinions about things that don't matter.
There's a social movement forming in this country. A group of people long marginalized have come together and will no longer be ignored.
Wait, the Harvest Moon cosplayers?
They have faced hardship and bitterness.
Oh, GameCube players over the age of 12.
But their bitterness has now reached a point of white hot rage.
Unitarians?
I'm of course speaking about Little Brothers. Their long history of being abused has reached a point that simple hair pulling and snail down dress pudding cannot satisfy. A rage nowhere more poetically expressed than in Raze's Hell. Here's a review.
You can't wage a preemptive expansionist war without some incidental collateral damage. Why didn't you just say that?
Welcome to Raze's Hell. Cutopia is a state run by Focus on the Family, led by a princess with manifest destiny on her mind.
I have decided that it is our solemn duty to bring our infinite bounty to those less fortunate than us.
So the Culets decide to colonize the rest of the planet in an effort to clean up their happy homeworld.
When he returned to his village to find it being saved, all he could do was stand there in shock and awe.
Personally, I think a concentrated campaign of long-term cultural assimilation would have been more effective, but that's just me. Anyway, the puntastically named Raze is considered an outcast along with the rest of his beast-like people. One fateful day, while the Culets were cleansing his village...
Hey, where are you going? We're saving you from your horrible, icky ugliness!
Raze stumbles upon an artifact that infuses him with an organic power to free his people and exact revenge with a little cleansing of his own in an endless cycle of retribution.
Look at you, quite a change.
Yet behind the saccharine exterior and the plentiful opportunities for political jocularity lies a shooter with challenging AI, heaps of gun-toting action, suicidal teddy bears, and even Xbox Live support, which is surprising given the game costs only $20. As Raze, you harness the power of nature. You shoot projectiles derived from plants and vegetation. Instead of bullets, Raze fires bugs called squibs, which are collected from hives.
Now you can spit death.
Whenever Raze is low on health, he can inhale the giblets of his foes to replenish his vitality. The enemies are smart in this game. They will flank, seek help, sound alarms, and hunt you down rather than stay in one place waiting for you to attack. Though you can sometimes sneak up on them. And they are so darn cute with their little jack-in-the-boxes and lollipops of death.
You may have killed me, but thousands will rise.
Shut up, goddamn! But the gameplay? This is where it gets a little less interesting. It's pretty standard fare. And remember, this is still a budget title with its share of problems. The biggest concern is frame rate, which will shudder in large battles and co-op play. The level design is straightforward. There's only one way to do anything, and strategy usually involves thinning the crowd with sniper spittle, then running in, hacking, and gunning. There's also minigames, like golf. Yep. It's a fun concept, but it's a budget title, and it shows. I think his friend missed. If you're interested, it's worth a rental. If you're chewing your toenails right now just waiting for us to talk about Final Fantasy, then you can just forget about it. A 3 out of 5.
Oh, the little Culets are adorable. Why do we have to kill them?
The game is actually using their cuteness to send a complex political message that expansionist wars are wrong and that blowing up little teddy bear people is a lot of fun.
Between this and Oddworld Stranger's Wrath, I have to wonder if a new subgenre of goofy shooter with political undertones is emerging.
Dear God, let's hope not.
Hey, if you think you know more about games than us, go to the G4ia website.
G4TV.com/G4ia.
And vote for your favorite games.
And then tune into G4ia on August 9th to see who the winners are.
Till then, you could always blow up teddy bears. Night.